So, okay, let's continue. Okay, so yun nga, dapat tested and approved by the Department of Labor and Employment through Occupational Safety and Health Center. Okay, next, the usage of personal protective equipment in all establishments, projects, sites, and all other places where work is being undertaken shall be based on the evaluation and recommendation of the safety officer. So, dapat pala si safety officer ang nag-evaluate and nagre-recommend ng type of PPE na gagamitin ng mga workers or employees. Okay? All PPE must be of appropriate size, weight, and type to specific workers exposed to hazards from which PPE are meant to ensure effective protection. So basically, dapat yung personal protective equipment na ibibigay natin sa mga employees, dapat appropriate naman yung ano, yung size, yung weight, dapat kasya sa kanya, lapat sa kanya at tamang-tama sa kanya para ma-serve yung purpose na protection of employees. Huwag yung masyadong maluwag, huwag yung masyadong malaki, masyadong mahaba. Kasi factor din 'yon para maano, hindi ma-achieve yung purpose ng personal protective equipments. Okay? Failure to provide appropriate PPE in high-risk activities shall give rise to the right of the worker to refuse unsafe work. So, yun nga, yung example natin kanina sa workers' rights to refuse unsafe work. Pag hindi nabigyan ng tamang PPE, may karapatan ng employee or yung worker na hindi gawin yung trabaho. Okay? Section 9, safety signage and devices. Okay? All establishments, projects, sites, and all other places where work is being undertaken shall have safety signages and devices to warn the workers and the public of the hazards in the workplace. Basically, yung mga safety signages na to, bago magsimula ang trabaho or sa kahit sa ang workplace, dapat meron tayong mga signage na nagbibigay ng warning for both workers and the public dun sa mga hazards associated dun sa lugar. Okay? Safety signage and devices shall be posted in prominent positions and strategic locations. Dapat madaling naiintindihan. Okay? And in accordance with the OSH standards on color of signs for safety instructions and warnings, yung GHS na yan, yung globally harmonized system, yung mga pictograms, kasi hindi tayo basta-basta naglalagay ng mga signage or mga safety signages sa workplace natin. Meron din tayo dyan mga provisions or meron din tayo mga standard, may mga ruling din tayo dyan sa colors, sa designs, and sa mga pictograms na ginagamit. Like sa construction safety, yung classifications and labeling of chemicals, radiation, safety instructions, and warning signs set by the Department of Labor and Employment. All signage shall also be of appropriate quality to ensure their legibility. Section 10, safety in the use of equipment. Commonly sa mga manufacturing, sa mga services, and especially sa construction, applicable tong safety in the use of equipment na to. Yung provision for this section, makikita nyo kung ano ba yung safety in the use of equipment. In relation to the use of equipment, such as but not limited to earth-moving equipment, heavy-duty equipment, materials handling equipment, and construction equipment, the employer, contractor, or subcontractor, if any, must comply with the OSH standard set by DOLE on safety and use of such in the different phases of the company or project operation, including the transport to and from the establishment, project, site, or place where work is being undertaken. Appropriate training and certification by the Technical Education and Skills Development Authority, yung TESDA, Professional Regulation Commission, or other concerned government agency shall be requirement for operators before use of equipment. So yun, malinaw. Hindi pala sa use of equipment pala, dapat yung mga workers natin are certified by the Technical Education and Skills Development Authority. Yung TESDA na yan. Dapat meron silang certification na eligible sila to use the equipment dahil nang nag-undergo sila ng proper training on how to use the specific equipment as well as the Professional Regulations Commission, if any. Okay? Yun lang yun. For example, yung madaling example natin. Sa ambulance, okay? Yung ambulance natin, dapat hindi siya nadadrive ng mga incompetent or yung mga hindi talaga duly licensed na drivers. Okay? Kaya hindi ko mo marunong kang magmaneho, pwede mong i-drive yung ambulance natin. Kasi may mga regulations tayo yan. Dapat meron kang professional license, assigned ka dun sa specific task na yon, and then meron kang proper training kung paano mong gagawin yung trabaho para maiwasan natin yung mga aksidente. Section 12, Occupational Safety and Health Program. Ito, isa rin to sa part ng reportorial namin annually. Okay, ito yung isang makapal na libro, yung compilation ng lahat ng programs or yung prescribed components ng Occupational Safety and Health Program dito sa ating establishment sa hospital. Well, basically, pag ganito yung mga services, yung establishment, ang ginagawa natin ay Occupational Safety and Health Program. For construction, ang tawag naman sa kanila is Construction Safety and Health Program. Okay? Magkaiba yun. So, coverage, covered workplaces shall develop and implement a suitable OSH program in a format prescribed by DOLE which shall be posted in prominent places. Okay. In our case, ang ginagamit nating format o yung template is yung comprehensive because yung classifications ng establishments natin, yung school and hospital is a high-risk establishment. So, ang template na ginagamit ko dito is yung comprehensive type. Okay? Yan. Yan na yung actual picture nung, nung ating Occupational Safety and Health Program. That's for year 2021. Section 13, the OSH Committee or the Occupational Safety and Health Committee. Okay? So, requirement din pala to sa batas. Bakit? Bakit ba meron pa tayong Safety and Health Committee dito sa FEU-NRMN? That's because isa rin to sa mga requirements ng Department of Labor and Employment. Okay? For establishments with less than 10 workers and low-risk establishment, an SO1 shall be established, an OSH committee composed of the following. Okay? Yung chairperson, yung may-ari ng, for example, yung less than 10 workers na establishment, for example, food stall, less than 10 workers lang sila. Ang type ng OSH committee na established niya dapat is composed of a chairperson, yung may-ari ng tindahan, and automatic, the secretary will be the safety officer of the workplace, and some member. Okay, pwedeng yung cashier, pwedeng yung dining person. Yan lang yung composition nila for type A. The OSH committee shall effectively plan, develop, oversee, and monitor the implementation of the OSH program. Yan, pare-pareho lang kami yan sa type B, sa mga high-risk establishment. Lahat naman ng committee, they are tasked to plan, develop, oversee, and monitor the implementation of the OSH program. Okay? The safety officer of the workplace may also be the owner. So, malinaw, pwede pala na si yung owner din ng establishment ay mag-take ng training ng safety officer and pwede siyang dual. Siya na yung chairperson, siya rin yung safety officer. Okay? From the Philippine Red Cross or any duly recognized organization. Of course, sa accredited training school ka dapat mag-take ng safety training. Okay? For two or more establishments, house under one building, for example, sa isang building, merong tatlo. Merong tatlong establishment na naka-house. Okay? Ito naman yung composition ng kanilang dapat na composition ng kanilang safety and health committee. We have the chairperson or the building owner or his or her representative such as the building administrator. Pwede yon na maging chairman. Okay? Again, secretary will be the safety officer of the building or complex appointed by the chairperson. Okay? And members for at least two safety officers from any of the establishment house, kung tatlo yung establishment doon, kunin nila yung dalawang safety officer as members and at least two workers representatives, one of which must be from a union. In our case, na-apply din natin to. If from any of the establishment house under the building or complex. The building administrator shall ensure that the joint OSH committee shall submit its organizational plans and minutes to the Dole Regional Office. Ganon din sa amin. Copy furnish ang Bureau of Working Conditions. Ganon din yung aming submissions. Pero it doesn't apply sa ating case kasi sa atin, high-risk establishment with more than 400 employees. No? Ito na. Yung actual health and safety committee ng FEUNRMF. Okay? We have our chairman and also our chief operating officer, Mr. Juan Enrique J. Reyes. Siya yung health and safety committee chairman. And sabi nga, dun sa rule, the safety officer must be the health and safety secretary of the organization. Okay? We also have these members, also our occupational health personnel. We have patient safety officer. We have occupational health nurse. We have the occupational health dentist, our certified first aider, and our mental health officer, and of course the admin assistant and ex-officio members then. We also have these representatives from other parties like yung mga service providers natin and one representative from the union, yung president ng ating union, si Mr. Pancho Manukom. And we have representative from housekeeping service, a representative from construction, representative from aircon technicians, and representative from the security service provider. Okay? Yun. Yun yung composition ng ating health and safety committee. Okay? And ibig sabihin nun, yung isang rule natin, yung pag-establish ng health and safety committee is na-comply natin. Okay, section 14. Sa mga hindi po nakakaalam, yung safety officer. Okay? Ito na po. Palilinawin na natin kung ano talaga yung role ng safety officer sa establishment. Okay? In the implementation of OSH program, safety officers shall be employed or designated with the following duties and responsibilities. Number one, oversee the overall management of the occupational safety and health program in coordination with the Occupational Safety and Health Committee. Okay? Nangyayari po yan. Frequently monitor and inspect any health or safety aspect of the operation. So, sa atin, we have the hospital, we have the school. So, frequent monitoring tayo ng health and safety aspects. Okay? Assist government inspectors in the conduct of safety and health inspection at any time whenever work is being performed. Okay? Number 4, naka-highlight nga dito, safety officers to issue work stoppage order when necessary based on the requirements and procedures provided by the occupational safety and health standards. Okay? Under safety officer pa rin, para mas maintindihan ulit natin. Okay, sabi, safety officer of all workplace must possess the necessary training and experience requirement according to its category as contained herein. Okay? Sa category, sa column ng category, nakikita nyo, we have, di ba, we have four classifications of safety officer. Safety officer 1, safety officer 2, safety officer 3, and safety officer 4. Okay? Nandito din yung mga prescribed training on occupational safety and health, no? Para ma-appoint ka or para mag-qualify ka for different categories ng safety officer. Number 1, for safety officer 1, sabi nga, simply take the mandatory 8 hours occupational safety and health orientation course. Ito yon. And another 2 hours of train the trainers training. Okay? And then, safety officer 1 ka na, pag na-certify ka dyan. Then, for safety officer 2, you need to have a mandatory 40-hour basic occupational safety and health training or construction occupational safety and health training. Pero yan, mandatory 40 hours. Basta kung ano yung applicable sa trabaho, kunyari, nasa construction industry ka, dapat ang kunin mo, COSH. Pero kung nasa services ka or mga manufacturing, kailangan kunin mo, BOSH. Okay? For safety officer 3 naman, you need to have this mandatory 40 hours basic OSH or COSH applicable to the industry and additional 48 hours of advanced or specialized occupational safety and health training course relevant to the industry. And of course, other requirements as prescribed by the occupational safety and health standards such as you at least have 2 years of experience in OSH-related career. Okay? Lastly, yung safety officer 4, yung SO4 na tinatawag is, ang requirement naman niya for training is mandatory for 40 hours OSH or COSH, BOSH or COSH, and additional, kung kanina sa safety officer 3, 48 hours yung required advanced or specialized trainings, dito sa SO4, kailangan meron kang additional 80 hours of advanced or specialized occupational safety and health training course relevant to the industry. And also, may other requirements pa rin na actual experience as SO3 for at least 4 years. So, ngayon, dahil nga ang it was implemented pa lang last January 2019, so wala pang SO4 sa Pilipinas. So, nasa SO3 level pa lang yung ating mga officers kasi kailangan mag-gain sila ng 4-year experience. So, most probably, 2019, 20, 21, 22, 23, by year 2023, may mga applicants na tayo for safety officer 4. The respective qualifications of safety officers are yung mga binanggit ko na yan. Okay? Karugtong lang to nung sa ano, sa safety officer 4, an aggregate of 320 hours of OSH-related training. Sabi nga, yan yung iniipon namin na number of hours ng trainings na binibigay namin and also yung trainings na na-attend namin. Yun yung aggregate na 320 hours. Okay? And actual experience as SO3 for at least 4 years. Yan, inulit ko lang. Safety officers engaged in micro and small establishment, low to medium risk, shall be engaged in safety programs including other tasks designated by his employees. In the case of a contractor or subcontractor, at least one safety officer must be deployed at each specific area or project, okay, to oversee the management of the OSH program and its own workforce. So, malinaw, para sa mga contractors and subcontractors dyan, dapat pala sa bawat project o sa bawat area of work nyo, kailangan meron kayo naka-deploy ni isang safety officer, depende dun sa categories ng inyong project, kung safety officer 2 or safety officer 3 ba yung requirements nyo, to oversee the overall management of occupational safety and health program of your own workforce. So, hindi pala komo dito ka sa FEU-NRMF. Nagkaroon ng project, dito ka gumagawa, dito ka may construction, ang magiging safety officer mo is yung safety officer ng institution. Hindi pala ganun. Dapat, you should have your own safety officer deployed from your own workforce. Okay? Linaw? Okay. Ito yung classifications and number of safety officer for all covered workplaces. Okay? Ibig sabihin lang, nandito yung dito nyo makikita kung ilang safety officer ba ang required or anong classifications ng establishment at ilang safety officer ang requirement. Okay? Huwag na natin tingnan yung buong chart, no? Focus tayo dito sa high risk. Okay? Ito yung high risk. Dito tayo belong, di ba? Dito tayo nakasama sa high risk. And then, total number of employees, palagay natin kasi statistically, we have more than 800, no? So, dito tayo pupunta sa row na to. Yung 251 to 500 and 501 to 750 employees. Okay? Kasi pareho lang yung requirements niya kung titingnan nyo. Dito na tayo sa high risk, di ba? Ito yung requirements ng safety officers para sa FEU-NRMF. Okay? 1 SO2 and 2 SO3. Okay? So, yun pala dapat ang meron tayong number of safety officers based on classification. Okay? Okay, additional 1 for every additional 250 in fraction thereof. Okay, the engagement of the services of the certified OSH consultant or yung SO4 shall be allowed for a period not longer than 1 year for establishment. Pwede pala yun. Kung magkakaroon na tayo ng SO4 sa Pilipinas by the year 2023, pwede pala yun mag-hire ka ng isang consultant na SO4 category and pwede naman pala siya for 1 year. Okay? Whose safety officer is in the process of completing the required training courses and relevant experiences. So, habang wala ka pang, halimbawa lang, wala ka pang safety officer na dedicated or appointed dito sa FEU-NRMF, pwede kang kumuha ng isang consultant in SO4 level, no? For not longer than 1 year. Pwede naman pala yun. Section 15, kung merong safety officer provisions, meron din occupational health, personnel, and facilities. Iba naman to. Medyo yung safety officer, nakabukod siya. And then, we have these occupational health, personnel, and facilities na requirement din dun sa ating OSH program. Okay? Tingnan ulit natin, no? So, low risk, medium to high risk, dito ulit tayo magpo-focus dito sa table na to. Kasi hindi tayo applicable dito sa low risk, nandito tayo sa high risk. Okay? Titingnan ulit natin, no? Ang ating population is, palagay natin dito sa 501 up to 2,000. Okay, tingnan natin ha, dito sa table na to. First aider requirements, dito sa number na to, sa 501 up to 2,000, kailangan meron ka palang 6 to 20 certified first aiders for you to comply with section 15. Okay? For occupational health nurse, you must have one full-time occupational health nurse. In our case, we have our occupational health nurse, si Ms. Kayen, si Ms. Kayen Lalas ng SPS Clinic. Siya yung ating occupational health nurse. Nag-undergo siya ng Bosch training for occupational health nurse. Okay? For occupational health dentist, okay, kailangan daw meron ka rin isang full-time. Or, kung wala ka isang full-time, dapat meron kang agreement with other hospital or other clinic na supported with MOA. Okay? For OHP siya naman, kailangan, in this number, kailangan meron kang dalawang part-time or isang full-time na OH physician na assigned for employees. Okay? For facilities, ito, okay naman tayo dito. Kasi nga, hospital-based tayo and meron din tayong medical clinic. Complied naman tayo dito sa occupational health facilities. Okay? Pero if you want to discuss kung ano ba yung mga classifications and required numbers, andito lang ulit yon. Dito na naman tayo titingin sa 501 to 750 or 751 employees up to 1,000. Then, makikita nyo dito ulit sa table ng high risk, dito nyo ulit makikita yung required numbers. First aid treatment room to. Clinics and the total number of beds. Then, sa hospital, yung number of beds. Okay? Section 15, OH personnel and facilities pa rin, no? The employer may not establish a hospital or dental clinic in the workplace. Pwede pala yun. Pwede naman palang walang clinic, walang hospital, or walang dental clinic. Where there is a hospital or dental clinic which is located not more than 5 kilometers away from the workplace. So, malinaw yung nasa provision, no? Kung wala kang hospital or wala kang dental clinic at ikaw isang establishment and then meron kang requirements na OH facilities na to have this first aid treatment bed, yung hospital bed and dental clinic, ganito yung pwede mong gawin. Or not more than 5 kilometers away from the workplace, accessible in not more than 25 minutes. Yun lang yung mga tatandaan natin, travel time. And the employer has facilities readily available for transporting workers to the hospital or dental clinic in cases of emergency. So, dapat lang meron kang dedicated or sasakyan na gagamitin mo for transport pag kinailangan mong mag-transfer na injured person sa hospital or kahit papunta sa clinic. For this purpose, the employer shall enter into a written contract. Dapat pala may memorandum of agreement with the hospital for the use of such hospital for the treatment of workers in cases of emergency. So, basically, dapat meron siyang memorandum of agreement. Yun yung proof na pwede mong ipakita or mag-justify for your compliance dun sa OH facilities. Okay, for safety and health training under section 16, okay, sabi, sa letter A, all safety and health personnel shall undergo the mandatory orientation or training on occupational safety and health as prescribed by DOLE. Baka mali to kayo ha. This refers to the safety and health personnel, including the safety officers, the occupational health personnel. Yun lang to ha, hindi to para sa mga employees. Okay? Sabihin ko lang, sa safety officer 1, sabi nga, mandatory 8 hours OSH training, tapos 2 hours ng train the trainers. Safety officer 2, kailangan meron siyang 40 hours OSH training or COSH. Safety Officer 3, yung mandatory 40 hours of training and additional 48 hours advanced or specialized trainings and other requirements may be prescribed. Okay? sa safety officer 4, mandatory 40 hours, additional 80 hours advance, and aggregate of 320 hours of OSH-related trainings. So, pag wala itong mga prescribed trainings na to, hindi mo siya pwedeng i-assign as a safety officer sa inyong establishment. Okay? So, continue sa first aider, kailangan standard first aid training. Sa OH nurse, kailangan at least 40-hour basic OSH training course for OH nurses. Iba po yun sa BOSH na sinasabi ko kanina, sa BOSH and COSH. Ito namang basic occupational safety and health training course for OH nurses, iba po yan. Sa dentist naman, at least 40 hours BOSH, pwede. Ang occupational health physician, katulad din ni OH nurse, kailangan at least meron siyang mas marami lang yung total number of hours niya. 56 hours basic OSH training course for occupational health physician. So, hindi pala pwedeng mag-assign lang basta-basta ng safety officer, no? Kailangan pala, meron siyang prescribed trainings, prescribed ng DOLE. Ito yung mga requirements bago mo siya i-assign as safety officer of your establishment. And dito rin sa occupational health nurse, meron ding specific trainings for OH nurses, ganun din sa OH physician. Hindi pala dahil physician siya, pwede na siyang i-appoint ng establishment as the occupational health physician. Kasi merong prescribed training talaga, yung BOSH training course for OH physician. Okay? Letter B, all workers shall undergo the mandatory workers. Ito na nga po yun. Kaya tayo ma-attend ngayon ng mandatory OSH training kasi ito na yung provision niya, no? Sa section 16, kung ang mga safety and health personnel are required to undergo training accredited by DOLE, yung mga employees pala or yung workers shall undergo the mandatory workers. Pag sinabing mandatory, kailangan po nating gawin. Kailangan nating sundin. Okay? Undergo the mandatory workers OSH seminar as prescribed by DOLE. Kaya ako nga pinakita kanina yung complete training course kasi yun din yung sinusunod namin, yun ang galing sa DOLE, no? Which shall be jointly participated by workers and employers. So, hindi lang pala ang mga empleyado and workers ang kailangan nag-a-attend ng mandatory OSH trainings. This can be jointly participated by workers and employers, ng mga stakeholders natin, no? Especially yung mga department heads and mga head of the section. Okay? Standardized training module for safety and health personnel shall be implemented and updated regularly as necessary. Okay? So, yun nga. Pwede naming i-modify dun sa based on the operation, type of the operation na meron kami, pero hindi namin pwedeng baguhin yun kasi standardized yung training course ng mga modules na ginagamit namin. Okay? The mandatory workers OSH seminar may be conducted by the safety officer of the establishment or any certified OSH practitioner or consultant. Okay? Kung yung safety officer nyo is not capable of doing trainings or giving education to the workers as well as the employers, pwede kayong kumuha ng OSH practitioner or consultant. Okay? Aso, may bayad na yan. Itong kay safety officer, pag kaya niya mag-training, ibig sabihin, yung ibabayad mo dito kay OSH practitioner or consultant, mawawala na. So, cost management. Okay? The workers OSH seminar and other trainings or orientations as required by the employer and by any law shall be at no cost. Sabi nga, hindi dapat maningil. Okay? Hindi dapat maningil sa empleyado pag nagkakonduct ng trainings or orientations pagdating sa safety and health. No cost on the worker and considered as compensable working time. Ibig sabihin, kahit naka-time in ka, naka-attend ka ng trainings, naka-time in ka pa rin. Okay? Yun yung ibig sabihin ng as compensable working time. Okay? All personnel engaged in the operation, erection, dismantling of equipment, and scaffolds, structural erections, excavations, sinabi na lahat, no? Blasting operations, demolition, confined spaces, hazardous chemicals, welding, flame cutting, shall undergo specialized instruction and training on said activities. Sabi ko nga, pag yung mga skilled worker natin, dapat duly certified sila ng TESDA, okay? Bago sila isabak dun sa mga ganong klaseng critical jobs. Okay? Such training shall include, among others, topics on safety and specialized PPE. Requirements for said high-risk work activities, including the use of application and handling of the same, which can be provided by the DOLE. Okay? Section 17, the Occupational Safety and Health Reports. Ito, medyo para sa amin kasi I represent the FEUNRMF for these reportorials. So, ang part nyo lang dito as an employee is, for, halimbawa, meron akong hiningin data, meron akong hiningin information with regards to these reportorials or mga report requirements namin sa DOLE. Kailangan, tulungan nyo akong makuha or ibigay nyo sa akin kung ano yung hinihingi ko. Kasi, yun yung magiging attachment namin dun sa DOLE reportorials. Okay? All employers, contractors, or subcontractors, if any, shall submit to DOLE all safety and health reports and notifications such as, but not limited to, annual medical report, OSH committee report, employer's work accident or injury report, yung WAIR na tinatawag na yan, and annual accident or injury exposure data report, yung AEDR, plus the occupational safety and health program. Okay? Yung acronym, para madaling tandaan, para hindi mo malimutan, WARMA. Yung W for Work Accident and Illness Report, sinasubmit yan 20th day of the following month. So, for example, yung report ko ng December shall be submitted on the 20th day of January. Okay? The letter A for Annual Work Accident or Injury Exposure Data Report will be submitted every end of the month. By January 30 for the whole year, for example, yung 2021 AEDR ko, kailangan masubmit ko siya by January, before January 30. Okay? Letter R, Report of Safety Organizational Report. Annually yan. Kasama yan lagi. Isang kompletong package yan pag nagsasubmit tayo ng reports. Minutes of OSH committee meeting, quarterly. So, dapat pala, meron kaming na kikreate na minutes of the meeting with the OSH committee. Kasi requirements din namin yon as our annual reportorial. Ito nga, quarterly yung minutes, no? And of course, letter A again, annual medical report, dapat yan, nakasubmit na before March 30 of the following year. Okay? Yan lang yun. For Section 19, Workers' Welfare Facilities. All establishments, projects, sites, and all other places where work is being undertaken shall have the following free welfare facilities in order to ensure humane working condition. Okay? Meron naman tayo nito lahat, pero babasahin ko na rin, no? Letter A, adequate supply of safe drinking water. And letter B, adequate sanitary and washing facilities, suitable living accommodation for workers as may be applicable. For now, in our case nga, dahil nga kinailangan nating mag-provide ng accommodation for our healthcare workers, yung isang building natin is dinesignate natin to be their living accommodation, no? Yung pwede nilang sleeping quarters or pahingahan para hindi na sila na travel ng everyday kasi mahirap yung transportation due to pandemic. Okay? Separate sanitary, washing, and sleeping facilities for all gender as may be applicable. Okay? Lactation station, except those establishment as provided for under DOLE Department Order Number 143-15. Ito, requirement din tong lactation station na to, pero may exemption yan. Pag ang DOLE, na-issuehan ka na tawag doon, exemption eh. Exemption certification, which is under Department Order Number 14315, kailangan meron ka nun. Kung wala kang lactation station, kumuha ka ng exemption certificate. Okay? Ramps, railings, and the likes, and letter G, other workers' welfare facilities as may be prescribed by the OSH standards and other issuances. Okay? Kanina ko pa binabanggit yung occupational safety and health standards, no? Ito yung itsura niya. Yan yung aming book of safety. Diyan namin lahat kinukuha yung set of standards, yung safety orders, yung mga rules. Diyan ang basihan namin. Okay? All employers, contractors, and subcontractors, if any, shall comply with other occupational safety and health standards as provided for in the 1978 DOLE Occupational Safety and Health Standards. As amended, the newest version was the 2019 revisions. Pero imagine 1978 pa lang meron ng DOLE Occupational Safety and Health Standards, which was strengthened noong January 2019 under Republic Act 11058. This is an act of strengthening the compliance to occupational safety and health standards and providing penalties for violations thereof. Yun lang pala, in-intensify lang yung compliance dun sa lumang-luma na pala tong DOLE occupational safety and health standards, no? 1978 pa siya. Pero yung revision niya, yung pinakahuling revision, was 2019. I think it's May 2019. So, kaya bago na yan. Nakasabay na siya lahat ngayon sa ating regulations. Okay. Yung mga laman nito, yung occupational safety and health standards, kuha lang tayo ng ilan, no? Okay. For example, under this book, kuha lang tayo ng ilang examples, no? Ganito yung mga laman niya. For example, Rule 1070, yung Occupational Health and Environmental Control. Dito, makikita mo yung mga provisions. The employer shall exert efforts to maintain and control the working environment in comfortable and healthy conditions for the purpose of promoting and maintaining the health of his workers. Employer shall carry out work environment measure where hazardous work is performed and shall keep a record of such measurement which shall be made available to the enforcing authority. Yung work environment measurement na yan, yan yung kinakandak to measure yung kung sa noise, sa vibrations, yung illuminations, yan mo mami-measure para makita mo kung kailangan bang i-improve or kailangan bang bawasan yung masyadong maingay na nakakaapekto, no? Ayan. It includes temperature, humidity test, pressure, illumination, ventilation, concentration of substances, and yung noise, sabi mo. WEM shall be performed periodically as may be necessary but not longer than annually. So, pwede kang humingi ng tulong sa Occupational Safety and Health Center, pwede ka mag-request to do a WEM sa ating facility. Another rule, another example is yung Rule 1967, which is the physical examination. Okay, number one, all workers, irrespective of age and sex, shall undergo physical examinations. before entering employment for the first time. Okay? Periodically or at such intervals as may be necessary on account of the conditions or risk involved in the work. Okay? When transferred or separated from employment and when injured or ill. Okay, number two, all examinations shall be complete and thorough. Okay, meron naman tayong checklist niyan sa with HR and the medical clinic. Meron tayong complete list niyan, yung pre-employment. Okay, be rendered free of charge to the workers and include x-ray or special laboratory examination when necessary due to peculiar nature of the employment. So, ang dami pala, no? Okay. So, Section 23 naman, yung visitorial powers of the Secretary of Labor and Employment. Basahin natin to, ah. The conduct of annual spot audit must be attended by a safety officer and representative of the management and workers. Basically, yung member ng Health and Safety Committee, dapat nakasama siya dun sa visiting team. Okay. In the absence of the safety officer, his duly authorized representative may attend in his stead. The Secretary of Labor and Employment or his or her duly authorized representatives can enter workplaces at any time. So, kahit kailan pala pwedeng pumasok yung mga inspecting body, no? Okay? Or of the day or night where work is being performed, basta bukas at merong mga nagtatrabaho, no, to examine records and investigate facts, conditions, or matters necessary to determine compliance of establishments with the provisions of these rules and applicable laws. Kaya nga natin inaalagaan yung set of standards and yung mga list of compliance natin dun sa Department of Labor and Employment para pag dumating yung inspecting body or yung visiting team from the Department of Labor and Employment to check kung yung to examine yung lahat ng records, yung conditions, yung mga lahat na pwede nilang tingnan pertaining to the compliance of the OSH rules. Okay? And the applicable laws. Kaya nga, masyado tayong maingat at masyado tayong mahigpit pagdating dyan sa implementation kasi ano yung ipapakita namin na records? Ano yung madadat na nila na conditions kung hindi natin susundin yung mga rules and regulations? Okay? The Secretary of Labor and Employment or his or her duly authorized representatives may order stoppage of work or suspension of operation of any unit or department of an establishment when non-compliance to these rules. Ayun. Yun pala ang mangyayari. Pagka napatunayan na meron tayong violations or non-compliant tayo sa mga rules and sa mga OSH standards, mangyayari pala, ipapa-stop nila yung ating operation. Okay? OSH standards and other applicable laws poses grave and imminent danger to the safety and health of workers. So, kaya nga kailangan namin hindi lang dapat yung mga mata namin ang makakita ng mga imminent dangers na yan or kahit yung mga hazards na makikita nyo sa sections or sa mga areas nyo. Dapat kayo din as an employee, kailangan nare-report nyo sa mga supervisors nyo and then your supervisors, sila na yung mag co-coordinate sa amin para makapagbigay kami ng recommendation on how are we going to correct yung mga observed hazards or yung ma-eliminate kung meron mang imminent danger na na-observe. Okay? So, kailangan ng tulong ng lahat ng mga employees or ng mga workers pagdating sa reporting of unsafe conditions or imminent dangers. Okay, yun lang naman yun. Department Order Number 183 Series of 2017 and the Manual of Execution of Judgments shall govern the procedures in the conduct of inspection, mandatory conference, issuance of order and execution thereof. So, dito kasi, ano lang, simplify na lang natin, no? Halimbawa, nag-visit ang Secretary of Labor and Employment and meron silang nakitang mga areas na non-compliance, okay? May mga violations. Ganito yan. Lalagay nila dun sa inspection report yung mga issues na nakita nila, yung na-determine na ito, hindi, walang health and safety committee, ito, mga walang signages, ito, walang fire protection, ito, walang safety officer, ito, hindi naggagawa ng training, hindi nagbibigay ng education for all employees and workers. Itatag nilang lahat yung mga violations na yan with the corresponding penalty. Pero, bibigyan din nila tayo ng maximum of 90 days na palugit para may correct yung mga observed incompliance natin. So, hindi agad na kumuwala kang safety officer. So, that's 40,000. Then, 40,000 every day. Ganun kasi yung ano nun eh, yung charge ng penalty eh. Kung wala kang safety officer sa institution mo or hindi ka compliant sa having a safety officer, yung penalty mo will be 40,000 per day until such time na ma-comply mo yung violation. So imagine, 40 ngayon, 40 bukas, 40 susunod na araw, and that's very mahal, no? Kaya nga, ang Department of Labor and Employment, nagbibigay sila ng time, like the maximum of 90 days. Kailangan makapag-hire ka na ng safety officer mo in 90 days. Pagbalik ko at wala ka pa na na-hire na safety officer para dyan sa establishment mo, that's the time na i-serve nila yung monetary penalty. Kung ilang days yung naipon mo, de kung 90 days na yung lumipas tapos hindi mo na comply yung ano, yung issue mo. So 40,000 times 90 days. So, ganun 'yon. Ganun yung monetary form ng penalties ng occupational safety and health. In section 28, we have incentives to employers and workers. Sabi dito, there shall be established package of incentives under such rules and regulations as may be promulgated by the Department of Labor and Employment to qualify the employers and workers to recognize their efforts towards ensuring compliance with OSH and general labor standards, such as OSH training packages, additional protective equipments, technical guidance, recognition, awards, and other similar incentives. So, ibig sabihin, pag yung incentives for employers, magkagaling na yan sa ano, sa DOLE, through Occupational Safety and Health Center, pwedeng marerecognize sila for complying with the Occupational Safety and Health Standards and General Labor Standards. And for the employees naman, coming from the employers, yung simple things like yung free training packages, additional PPEs, yung technical guidance, education din, and recognition awards and other similar incentives. Okay? For section 27, under this RA 11058, employees' compensation claim. A worker may file claims for compensation benefits arising out of work-related disability or death. Such claims shall be processed independently of the finding of fault, gross negligence, or bad faith of the employer in a proceeding instituted for the purpose. The employer shall provide the necessary assistance to employees applying to claim. So, yun lang. Pinaka-iwanan ko lang sa inyo dito. The employer shall provide the necessary assistance to employees applying for these claims. Okay? Kasi it's an administrative matter na eh, no? Yung empleyado na aksidente, that's a work-related, gusto niyang mag-claim dun sa ECC, syempre dadaan niyan sa mga process, dadaan niyan sa investigation kung ano ba yung naging cause ng aksidente para mag-qualify siya dun sa claim. And the employer shall provide the necessary assistance to employees applying for claims. Okay? So that's it for Module 1. Thank you very much, dear participants. And keep safe always. See you again on the next modules. Meron pa tayong Module 2. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And thank you very much.